Welcome to this session. I am Priyanka Bidla and today we will see about block diagram reduction examples. These are the learning outcomes of this video lecture. At the end of this session, students will be able to reduce the block diagram using reduction rules, and second outcome will be evaluate the transfer function of the system using reduction rules. These are the contents of this video lecture. Now, recall the transformation rules for block diagram reduction. Those are studied in previous lecture. Now, pause the video for a minute and you have to recall the rules for block diagram reduction. Transformation rules. So, this table represents the all transformation rules. So, first rule, combine the blocks in cascade. If the blocks are connected in cascade, then multiplied with each other. So, here G1 and G2 are connected in series. Therefore, we take a product of transfer function of that block, that is G1 into G2. Next rule, combining blocks in parallel. Here, G1 and G2 blocks are connected in parallel. Therefore, G1 plus or minus G2. If there is positive sign, then we can add the blocks G1 plus G2. If there is negative, then we can write G1 minus G2. Next rule, moving a summing point after a block. So this is a summing point. This summing point is shifted after the block. While shifting a summing point after the block, add a block having transfer function as that of the same transfer function of that block, that is G. Next rule, moving a summing point ahead of a block. Here, this summing point is shifted before the block. While shifting a summing point before a block, add a block having transfer function as that of the reciprocal of the transfer function of that given block. So here 1 by G. Next rule, moving a takeoff point after of a block. So here this is a takeoff point and this takeoff point is shifted after the block. For that, add a block having transfer function as the reciprocal of the transfer function of that block, that is 1 by G. Then next rule, moving a takeoff point ahead of a block. So this takeoff point is shifted before the block with the help of add a block having transfer function as that of the same transfer function of that block, that is G. Then next, eliminating a feedback loop. Here this is a summing point and this one is the takeoff point. G is the forward path and H is the feedback path. Forward path is nothing input to the output and feedback path is nothing but from output to the input. If we want to eliminate a feedback loop, use this rule, that is G upon 1 minus plus G into H. Means if there is positive sign, then here write down minus sign. If there is minus, then write down positive sign. These are the rules for the block diagram reduction. Let us see the procedure to solve the block diagram reduction. There are total 6 steps. We see one by one step. Step 1. Reduce the blocks. Those are connected in series. Rule 2. Reduce the blocks connected in parallel. Next, step 3. Reduce the minor internal feedback loops. You have to eliminate the feedback loops. Then step 4. We will try to shift the all takeoff points towards right side and all summing points to the left side. Unless and until its requirement of problem, do not use rule 9 and 10. These two rules are critical rules. Then step 5. Repeat the above steps, that is step 1 to step 4, till getting the simplest form. And the step 6 is nothing but find out the transfer function of whole system after reducing the block diagram. So transfer function is equal to output upon input is nothing but C of S divided by R of S. Now consider first example, reduce the block diagram to canonical form. This is the given block diagram. Then first step is combine all cascade blocks. In this block diagram, there are G1 and G4 are connected in series and G2 and G3 are connected in parallel. So we solve the block diagram step by steps. Step 1, combine all cascade blocks. So here G1 and G4 are connected in series. So they get multiplied directly, G1 into G4. Then step 2, combine all parallel blocks. Here G2 and G3 are in parallel. So they get added directly, G2 plus G3. Then step 3, eliminate all minor feedback loops. So here H1 is in feedback with the G1, G4. And here is a positive sign. So use a standard formula and reduce the block diagram. That is G1, G4 divided by 1 minus G1 into G4 into H1. Step 4. Now, shifting all summing points to the left side and all takeoff points to the right side. Then step 5. Repeat steps 1 to 4 until the canonical form has been achieved for the particular input. So here these two blocks are connected in series, so they get multiplied with each other and we get the output. Now here again the H2 is in feedback with this block and here minus sign is there. So use the formula for eliminating the feedback loop. So apply the rule 4 for this. By reducing the loop containing H2, we obtain this block diagram. So this is the canonical form of the given block diagram. Here R of S is the input and C of S is the output. So transfer function is equal to output upon input, that is C of S divided by R of S, we get this output. This is nothing but this is the transfer function of the system. Now consider second example, simplify the block diagram and calculate the transfer function. So here R of S is the input and Y of S is the output. First we combine the series blocks, then we combine the parallel blocks, then eliminate the feedback loops. We see one by one step. So step 1 is use rule 2 for blocks G1 and G2 and rule 3 for blocks G3 and G4. So G1 and G2 are in series, so they get multiplied, and G3 and G4 are in parallel, so they are added, G3 plus G4. Now in this H1 is in feedback with the G1 into G2 block. So use rule 4 for blocks G1, G4, 2, G1, G2 and H1. After solving the block, we get this block G1 G2 divided by 1 plus G1 into G2 into H1. Now here shift a takeoff point. So next step is use rule 8 for shifting the takeoff point after the block G5. So here this is a takeoff point. Now shift a takeoff point after the block. At that time, add a block having transfer function as that of the reciprocal of the block. That is, instead of H2, here I am writing H2 upon G5. Then next rule, use rule 2 for blocks G3 plus G4 and G5. These blocks are connected in series, so they get multiplied G3 plus G4 into G5. Now in this, H3 is in feedback with this block. So eliminate this feedback loop with the help of rule 4 again. So use rule 4 for block G3 plus G4 into G5 and H3. So after simplification, we get this output. Here, these two blocks are connected in series. So again, using rule 2, they get multiplied directly and we get this output. Now, H2 upon G5 block is in feedback with this block. So again, eliminate this feedback loop with the help of rule 4. So we get the output. And this is nothing but this is the canonical form of given block diagram. If we want to calculate the transfer function of this system, then write down Y of S divided by R of S is equal to this. So this is the transfer function of that block. In this way, we have to reduce the block diagram as well as we have to calculate the transfer function of the system. These are the references of this video lecture. Thank you.